हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, लेट्स स्टार्ट थर्ड सेशन कंप्यूटर फंडामेंटल्स फ्रॉम सेकेंड यूनिट ऑफ क्लास 9 इंफॉर्मेशन टेक्नोलॉजी बुक। इन दिस सेशन वी अंडरस्टैंड अबाउट कंप्यूटर फंडामेंटल्स। अ कंप्यूटर सिस्टम इंक्लूड सॉफ्टवेयर एंड हार्डवेयर टुगेदर टू मेक इट परफॉर्म द रिक्वायर्ड टास्क। वेयर सॉफ्टवेयर इज अ कलेक्शन ऑफ इंस्ट्रक्शंस एंड रिलेटेड डाटा दैट टेल्स अ कंप्यूटर व्हाट टू डू एंड हाउ टू डू। And we can say in other words, software is a conceptual entity which contains a set of instructions with associated documentation related to the operations of a data processing system. And the computer hardware is a collection of electronic and other peripheral units which enables software to perform desired operations. And one more, there is an important software known as operating system, and that operating system is specially designed to establish the communication between various hardware devices and software loaded on a computer system. Let's understand these things through a diagram. So, if this is our hardware and this is our software loaded in computer system. These softwares are application software, and this is our hardwares or peripheral devices. So hardware have different devices like mouse, keyboard, CPU, printer and etc. So to communicate hardware devices and application software, we need a special software called operating system. This operating system acts like a bridge between hardware and application software, and the user can interact with operating system and application software both. So, the definition of computer is that a computer system is a programmable machine, means the computer system is programmable, so anyone can program this machine, and it is designed to perform arithmetic and logical operations to produce meaningful results in desired format or human understandable format, not in machine language. Now let's understand some relevant knowledge that a computer system is broadly divided into three units: input unit, central processing unit, CPU, and output unit. Here input unit helps the user to enter raw data and instruction into the computer system, and central processing unit performs the required operations as per given instructions. And at the end, output unit produces meaningful results in the desired format for the user. Here you can see the input, output and central processing unit. The first block, this is the block diagram of computer system. The first block is for input unit. The second block, there are four blocks, is CPU or central processing unit, and at the end, this is output unit. Through the output unit or output devices, we can see the result. There are some instructions given below, like this line showing the flow of data, and this shaded line show the flow of instructions. Here, let's understand that CPU is further divided into three parts. First part is control unit. Second part is arithmetic and logical unit. Third part is memory unit. Inside CPU, control unit acts as a receptionist and a manager of a company. It receives each and every instruction from user and coordinates between different parts to perform various operations. Then the arithmetic and logic unit act as a accountant of a company which performs all the mathematical and logical calculation, and memory unit acts as a temporary store of a company where a small amount of data is stored while other operations are being performed. In addition to these three units, a computer system also has a secondary storage device to hold or store large amount of data for later use by various applications running on it. So you can see here the secondary storage device is below the CPU. Now we must be wondering that how we can recognize these units in the form of real devices in personal computer system. So let's understand these units and through the pictures of these input and output units. We also describe these things into the previous session. Here input unit means mouse, keyboard and trackball, which acts as an input device of our computer system. And the output unit is our monitor where we can see the result, or the printer which print the result into hard copy. And between input unit and output unit there is CPU. CPU contains central, CPU means central processing unit. It contains control unit, arithmetical logical unit and memory unit. And central processing unit also contain place to hold secondary storage device such as hard disk to hold large amount of data and instructions, and compact disk, digital versatile disk, Blu-ray drive to keep data on portable disk. One of the most common output devices LED or LCD monitor, which is used as output unit to display the result coming out from our computer. So the computer system may also have some more additional devices connected to it to act as input or output devices as per requirement of an individual work. Some examples of input and output devices are given here, like input or output device mic. So mic, the purpose of mic is used to take the audio input and sample requirement to record nursery rhymes in the system. Then scanner used to accept digital input from a paper picture. Then camera used to accept image video inputs. Barcode reader used to read barcode. Printer used to print output on a paper. So printer and speaker are output devices. Using speaker we can listen the music, and by using printer we can print any assignment on paper or anything we can print on paper. Then the memory unit CPU is further divided into two components. One is known as random access memory. Random access memory is used to take care of intermediate storage of data while working on computer system. And the other memory is read-only memory, is used to keep the essential instructions written and stored by the manufacturer to load operating system and take care of basic input output operations, also referred as BIOS. So BIOS means basic input output system, and the BIOS is saved into read only memory so that computer can use this memory to start the other softwares, start the computer system. In the computer, the data is stored in the form of bits and bytes. Bit means binary digit and it is represented by 0 and 1. This is the smallest unit, storage unit. 8 bit combined together form a single byte, which in turn represent a single character. Let us see an example. If the name Ravi is required to be stored in computer, it will need 4 bytes in the computer's memory. The following table represents other higher units of computer memory. So we can see here kilobyte, megabyte, gigabyte and terabyte. We all are familiar with these memory units because of our mobiles or our smartphone have the memory, internal and external memory cards are also in GB, and at present the memory cards are not available in megabyte. So all the memory cards we found in market in GB. Some hard disks are in TB. TB means there are 1024 gigabyte or 210 GB. So RAM and ROM constitute the primary memory. So our computer have two types of memory. First is primary memory, second is storage memory, and third is flash memory. But we understand about here primary memory and secondary storage device, because a flash memory is also a secondary storage device that is external. So now let us discuss in detail about the various secondary storage devices. These are used to store large amount of data with capacity in the range 20 GB to 2 TB permanently on computer. The data is retained even the system is switched off. Hard disk is one of the most important secondary storage device, which is used to store operating system, office applications. Secondary storage devices, which is used to store operating system, office applications, utility software, and the user's data, etc. Apart from hard disk, one can always use additional secondary storage devices such as compact disk, digital versatile disk, Blu-ray disk, and their capacities is given here, that the capacity storage capacity of CD is 750 MB, the capacity of DVD is 4.5 GB, the capacity of Blu-ray disk is about 25 GB or 50 GB, pen drives with a storage capacity of up to 32 GB and more, and memory stick with the storage capacity of up to 32 GB or more. Now let us connect or check the connections between various parts of a personal computer and try to locate all the sockets or ports which are present behind the CPU cabinet, as shown here. So here we can see the back of our CPU where lots of ports are given. So let's start from the very first port. So here we can see there one is PS2 port. So PS2 ports are personal system 2 ports for connecting mouse and keyboard. Then USB port is for connecting USB devices. Here USB ports are given. Then and USB devices such as mouse, keyboard, printer, pen drive, etc. Then VGA port or video graphic adapter port is used to connect our monitor or screen. Then power port for connecting power supply. There are some other ports like serial port, and here audio jacks. Audio jacks are used to connect speaker and audio phones. When we connect or start our computer, so our computer should display some message from the manufacturer, and then it should start the operating system. Once the booting process is over, booting process means starting of the computer. There are two type of booting process, cold booting and warm booting. So cold booting means when the system starts from the beginning, and warm booting means when we restart the system. So when we restart the system doesn't need to do all the BIOS process, therefore it is a warm booting. So here you can see the picture of ports and cables, then firewire ports and port and cable, then Ethernet port and cables. So very first option or picture is about the USB port and cable. So USB port is a standard cable connection interface available on personal computers and some other electronic devices for data communication. USB ports allow standalone electronic devices to be connected with the help of cables to a computer. USB ports can also supply electric power across the cable to devices without their own. Then after FireWire ports, so FireWire ports are form of a serial port that make use of FireWire e-technology to transfer data rapidly from one electronic device to another. The FireWire port has ability to interact with a number of different devices, and a FireWire port can provide an ideal way to connect a scanner and a digital camera, or we can say a printer, to a computer. As the data transfer speed comparatively USB is very fast in the FireWire cable. Then the Ethernet port. The Ethernet port used to connect computers and other devices from a computer network. So Ethernet port used to create network. It uses Ethernet cables, establish efficient and effective communication between computers and other peripheral devices such as modem, router, multimedia, projector. So we can see these ports in our computer system also. This is all about your third session. Here some questions are given. What is input unit of a computer system? Then output unit of a computer system. So input unit used to give the instruction to the system, and output unit used to display the result. What is the job of central processing unit what is the job of control unit inside CPU? So control unit can control the flow of data and instructions. The job of control unit is like a manager of a company, and control unit receives each and every information from user and coordinates between different parts to perform various operations. Then what is the job of arithmetic logic unit inside the CPU? So inside the CPU, the arithmetic logic unit acts as an accountant of the company, which performs all the mathematical and logical operations. The next question is, name four input devices and write their type of input that can be entered through them into a computer system. Then sixth question is, name four output devices and write the type of output that can be exhibited through them. Again, let's see in a fast view then our this session has what. So in this session, first we understood the concept of software and hardware, then the concept of operating system, then we understood the block diagram of computer system, where input unit, central processing unit, and output unit are there. CPU has, there are three more units. Then we understand the input and output unit purpose, and after this we learned about the primary memory and secondary memory, and also learned about the BIOS, which saved into the read-only memory or ROM. Then we understood the concept of memory and memory units like KB, MB, GB and TB. Then we understand the about secondary storage device, which have hard disk, CD, DVD, Blu-ray disk, flash memory or memory stick. After this we understood the different ports that are available behind the CPU cabinet. After CPU cabinet we learned about the ports and cables. So this is all about your third session. In next session we understand about types of computers.